Heart of endurance and liberation. Soul of religion and peace. Witness of wars and suffering. The city of Hanoi stands tall and proud of its history over the years. The capital of Vietnam exhibits a mixture of religion, communism, and tradition. Temples, monuments, and symbols of power define the personality of Hanoi as a millenary city. My first contact with Hanoi is the ride from the airport to the city by taxi. The outskirts of Hanoi look a bit deserted at first sight, but my sensations change dramatically as we approach the city center. Escorted by motorcycles all around, I feel like in the middle of a stream that takes me to my destination much quicker. My taxi takes me to the Ho Chi Minh complex, erected in memory of Ho Chi Minh, president of Vietnam between 1954 and 1969. The Ho Chi Minh complex is an enormous meeting place. People from all regions in the country come and gather here to pay their respects to Ho Chi Minh as an important place of pilgrimage. The place is always crowded with groups of all ages visiting the gardens, the museum or the mausoleum. What is remarkable is the respectful way in which the local people behave. It's really overwhelming. In my visit to the gardens, I get amazed by the incredible figures in stone that I find in every corner. Different forms in different colors, but all of them spectacular. The gardens are well preserved and well treated at all times, being in perfect harmony with the traditional temples located between the mausoleum and the museum. An excellent place to sort out your mind and put your problems in order. The whole complex was erected in memory of Ho Chi Minh, the great revolutionary leader who was Prime Minister and President of the Democratic Republic of Vietnam, also known as North Vietnam. The mausoleum contains the remains of Ho Chi Minh as a means to pay homage to the dear Vietnamese leader that fought against the French and the Americans for the communist ideals. Close to the mausoleum, visitors can enjoy the Ho Chi Minh's museum. The whole museum is devoted to praising the figure of the dear leader. Not in vain, Ho Chi Minh represents the modern history of Vietnam forged in two consecutive wars during the 20th century. The Indochina War against the French between 1946 and 1954, and the Vietnam War, also known as the Resistance War against America. The museum contains an elaborate description of Ho Chi Minh's life, with 8 chronological topics and a collection of artifacts, miniatures, and various gifts gathered nationally and internationally. Resistance, communism, and liberation. Those were the values of a man that devoted his entire life to a striving for national independence. The center of Hanoi is a mess of narrow streets and alleys where the motorcycle is definitely the key. The streets of Hanoi have a special taste, something difficult to describe that makes it distinct among other cities in Southeast Asia. However, if I were asked about the main characteristics of Hanoi, I would say there are two main images that have lived on in my memory since my visit. One is a street food. Eating on the street is incredibly popular. There are bars and restaurants to enjoy the local cuisine literally everywhere. One can hardly miss it while strolling around. The other distinctive characteristic of Hanoi is traffic. I never saw so much two-wheeled traffic in my life. You can judge by yourself. no traffic rules apply at all. All you have to do is go your way while avoiding others. This is valid for cars, motorcycles and pedestrians. Although it may look chaotic, I didn't see any collision during my time in Hanoi. Amazing. The historical center of Hanoi offers a number of surprises. One is the Hoan Kiem Lake, meaning the Lake of the Restored Sword. The lake is one of the major scenic spots in the city and serves as a focal point for its public life. Near the northern shore of the lake lies the Jade Island, on which the Temple of the Jade Mountain stands. Jade Island is connected to the shore by the wooden red painted bridge called the Morning Sunlight Bridge. The island offers the perfect venue for locals and visitors to spend the day outdoors, taking pictures and socializing. The temple was erected in the 18th century. It honors the 13th century military leader Trang Hung Dao, who distinguished himself in the fight against the Yuan dynasty. It is no doubt one of the most interesting attractions in the city, offering cultural and leisure possibilities at the same time. The night in Hanoi is full of life, authentically spectacular. The degree of activity during the night time is even higher than that during the daylight. Something easy to understand if we consider the harsh weather conditions of Hanoi in terms of temperature and humidity. In summertime, it can reach up to 40 degrees Celsius and 90% of relative humidity. I'm out of there. Commercial activity on the street is especially intense. It is the best time of the day to go shopping, but not a good time in terms of traffic. If you want to know how it feels when you cross the street in Hanoi, just follow me. This is exactly what you see and how you feel in the middle of the jam. My recommendation is to walk slowly and to keep cool. You will see how all vehicles will avoid you easily. This is how it works. It's time to say goodbye to Hanoi. I hope this brief overview will arouse your curiosity for this city. If I ever have the chance, I will not hesitate to come back. Goodbye, Hanoi, y hasta siempre.